new one?
Yeah, I'm getting a Kia Soul.
No way.
What's up, man?
Guys,
up?
Look what? At this bench record. That no is crazy. Way. Who is this God. Guy? Who John Agaropoulos?
You're gonna be
wait, up. I've never heard of this guy before. Hold on.
So, we wanted to find the mean difference between Dom's benches and Mr. A's benches. So, we took an SRS of all of the mean benches and picked 7 for each of them. And then we checked the conditions that the samples are independent. And as previously stated, it was an SRS. And then we checked both the MPPs to find that they were both nearly linear. And then we did a 2-sample T-int to find the interval of 195.01 to 216.42 with degrees of freedom of 10.0449. To evaluate this interval, we said that we are 95% confident that the true mean difference in pounds bench between Mr. A and Dom is between 195.01 pounds and 216.42 pounds.
Oh, hey. Are you the
nice trainer?
I'm Swan. I'm the trainer from the gym.
Nice to meet you.
So you've been putting up some big weight out there. Why do you think I should take you into my training class?
I was just scrolling through one day, and I saw this guy who put up 405. That's insane.
That's insane.
405 on the bench? Are you kidding me? So I was like, you know what, I might as well try it. Like, I think you got the potential. So just we're gonna see. I'm hoping you can give me some good tips. So how should I start it out?
I can give you some tips, but you're gonna have to change a couple things.
Mm-hmm.
First,
what?
That's not a real lifting outfit.
Are you kidding me? This is super athletic.
No,
I'm used to like running stuff.
You need something like this.
What? Pants in summer? Are you sure?
If you want to get big, that's what you have to do.
Alright, I guess.
Wait, one more thing.
What?
What are you listening to those in there?
Old song, but
some smooth jazz.
Maybe
you need to cut that out. You need to be listening to heavy metal.
Heavy metal?
Heavy metal.
That's what it hurts my ears.
The loudest.
Really?
With the biggest bass lines.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Alright, I gotta add some song. My story's pretty full, but I'll add some song.
Okay, you might have to delete some.
Alright, I'll get to that.
What are you doing?
What do you mean? Why'd you stop that? I was just running. I was just trying to get better.
This isn't gonna help you get big.
What do you mean? It's working out.
Cardio doesn't work.
What do you mean?
You
like,
stop.
No, you like lose your gains?
Yes.
What?
This isn't gonna help you break the record.
God, get me away from that. Oh my God.
Huh? What are you listening to?
I was just deleting this. I was making room for that all that heavy metal. Hold on, just give me a second.
This isn't gonna help you break the record. You need to get serious right now.
I just want one more song. Hold on, it's like a warm up. It's a good warm up. It'll get me going. Just give me a second.
Taylor Swift is heard playing at the gym near Dom and Swanee. What is the probability that it's coming from Dom? To solve this problem, we need a tree, and the probability that Swanee's playing music is 0.5, and the probability that Dom is playing music is also 0.5. When Dom's playing music, the probability that it's Taylor Swift is 0.99, and the probability that it's not Taylor Swift is 0.01. When Swanee's playing music, the probability that it's Taylor Swift is 0.03, and the probability that it's not Taylor Swift is 0.97. We do the probability that Dom is listening to Taylor Swift, which is 0.95, divided by the sum that Dom is listening to Taylor Swift, and that Swanee is also listening to Taylor Swift. When we do that division, we get 0.9706, and that's the probability that the Taylor Swift is coming from Dom.
Alright, so change, I guess. I mean, looks alright. I don't notice not any bigger or anything, but...
You already look so bigger. The next step, if you want to be a champion, is you got to start recording
lifting?
Your lifts.
What? I had to record my lifts when we start lifting now?
Lifting is the very last step. You gotta record your lifts first.
Record my lifts? What do you mean? Like a notebook?
Yes.
Like a school notebook?
Yeah. I know school's hard for you, especially prop and stats.
Yeah.
But you have to start recording your lifts now.
Oh, okay. I guess so. That's sweet.
Yeah, that's good.
trying to beat John Agarwal's bench records?
Yeah.
I read about you. Okay, I'm a nutritionist. I can help you out.
Okay, yeah. I was just, so my trainer who I was working with was telling me to get, like, these products, but he didn't really give me any, like, guidelines. I'm not really sure what to get.
Oh, well, you need a lot of this stuff.
Okay.
Okay, first, most important, we're going to need this. All right.
What else?
This.
I mean, that's 35, and then that's probably another 40.
Probably some of this.
Oh, my God. Are you sure?
Oh, you need all of this. This is just, like, a week's worth. We'll come back.
1 week?
Yeah.
How much more do I need? Do I need, like, some more of these or anything? More of these, a couple more?
Probably a couple more.
A couple more. All right, just to be safe, I'll grab a couple more.
I mean, you want to beat the bench records,
yeah.
So.
Your time is up, my time is now. You can't. All right, so I got all my liftings written down here in the book. So what's next? We start stretching?
No. The first rule of lifting is to lift as big and fast as possible without stretching.
No stretching?
No stretching. Never.
Right to the max?
Right to the max.
Alright, so you do realize my max is 195. I'm trying to get 405. We're just do the lifts and
go right to it as hard as possible right now.
So these clothes and these liftings I have from like months ago, that's all I need?
You might need one more thing.
What is this? This looks like some chemicals. This is like chemicals like on the label.
Like you said, you didn't do well in school. This is chemistry. You need this to get big.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it works for me. Guess so. Let's get to it. That's sweet.
Then get ready.
We've done like nothing. I rang for like 10 seconds and I like didn't even stretch or anything.
No, it's time. I can sense it now.
Are you sure? What do you mean?
I'll tell you something. An old weightlifting legend once told me.
Mm-hmm.
It's not about the size of the dog in the fight. It's about the size of the fight of the dog. And that's what you gotta do.
I mean, I don't know, are you sure? Like, just because you can sense it doesn't, I mean, I'm the one lifting the 4.5.
You have to believe in here.
And that's what it's all about.
What's in here outweighs the 405 pounds.
I mean, alright, if you think I've been trained that, if I've had enough training, you know,
I'm 100%.
You think I'm ready.
It's on you now, I've done my
everything's on, yeah, it's, I trust you, man, you're a certified trainer, so.
I'm about to hit my max PR, 405 on bench, got my trusty stats book with me. Always carry this with me before I do anything. Just to touch up on my math here. Yep, success, failure, MPP, all that good stuff. P is low, reject the hoe. Let's see what else. Outliers, R squared adjusted. Comparing memes. Oh, I did awful in that chapter. I think I got like a 10 on my quiz. and then, oh, right here where I got all the answers for my homework. Perfect. Alright, I think we're good. Let's get this started.
If Dom's mean benches were now greater than Mr. A's. So we set our null hypothesis to the mean benches of Dom's are equal to the mean benches of Mr. A's. Our alternate hypothesis is that Dom's benches are now greater than Mr. A's benches. So over here we wrote Dom's new benches, which are 650, 680, 695, 700, 705, 665, and 685. And these were pulled from an SRS of Dom's new benches. Our conditions, both samples are independent, they're both SRSs, and the NPPs of both were nearly linear. So then we did a two sample t-test, and our t-value was 34.4064, with a p-value of 2.0445 times 10 to the negative 11th with 9.2915 degrees of freedom. And then with such a low p-value, we reject the null hypothesis. There is significant evidence to suggest Dom's mean bench is greater than Mr.